This time I want to make a video about my new Composition S100 here in the showroom. And this composition is made of lacquered inox. So stainless steel doors with a transparent lacquer on it, so it's hard to get stains on it. On the island I have a length of 3 meters, but on the left side I start with 2 base units with drawers and electrical opening. So as you can see, if you trigger the door, it opens itself complete. Like this. This is very convenient, right? Because you don't have to touch your doors with your dirty fingers. You know, if I cook, I have dirty fingers. Never mind. On the right part of the island, I have an overhanging piece with a space for your bar stools. And on the bottom, I have also LED light. And that makes it more elegant, how do you call it? And also on the sides and on the back, I have seating space. So in total, you have about 6 bar stool space. On the back side of the island, we have again a light below the worktop and also sockets below the worktop. And then, of course, again, cabinets with, like on the other side, the drawers and an inside drawer with a wooden cutlery tray. Finally, we have here sink unit, sockets also in the edge of the worktop, and then 2 worktops, a Corian worktop in white with an inlay in stainless steel. And I've done that because you can't put a hot pan on your Corian, because you know Corian cannot stand the heat, but you can do that on the stainless steel. And the stainless steel part also suits very well with my stainless steel doors. And in this stainless steel worktop there is a welded sink in a very big size, and you know, it's in one piece, so it's very clean. And behind the sink, of course, a tap with an extractable hand shower and also a built-in soap pump. You can fill this soap pump easily from the top. For the S100 Island, I've chosen for a nav induction hob with a double flex zone. And that means that you don't have different zones, but that the whole hob is usable for induction heating. So I can put my pan like everywhere, or I can use the accessory like this. This is a teppanyaki, and the whole surface of a teppanyaki is heated. This really works amazing, and I'll make more videos about it, about how to use it. The extractor hood of the S100 kitchen is integrated in the ceiling. It's made of white glass, so it's good looking. And I did it because you don't hurt your head on the hood. And the filter is hidden behind the glass. And of course, this filter you can clean in the dishwasher. And the hood has also light and a remote control. The wall with tall units has the same color as the island, also in lacquered inox. And behind the table part of the island, we have the built-in coffee machine and a dish warmer below. And the coffee machine you also can use for tea, but it makes excellent cappuccino, latte macchiato, ristretto, you know, everything what you can want with a coffee machine. And above and below, you have also the storage. Same story with a tool unit for the full steam oven. You have space below and on top, the same inox doors. And what I forgot to tell, also the back part of the doors is in metal, but in this case in aluminum. Next to the 2 tool units, we have 3 tool units with single doors and a big handle. The one on the right has the fridge freezer, or in this case the big fridge, because You know, if you have an extra space with a freezer, this is really amazing. But usually clients choose for a fridge freezer with a freezer below. And then we have two doors of 60, but they are folding. So it makes 120 in total. And behind the folding doors, we have space for a dishwasher on height. And below the dishwasher, we have space for the oven plates. Above, we have space for a small appliance like a steam oven or microwave oven, whatever you want. And in here, we have a nice wine cooler. Then we have space left for the glasses. I have also an accessory, not standard, included in the price, with a wooden thing to hold your wine glasses. LED light, sockets, and you know, a space for a blender or toaster, whatever you want. In the S100 kitchen, we have the full steam oven from Neff with the full touch display. This is the most sophisticated oven in the Neff line, and I'll show you how to make codfish in this oven. So you can see we have a big pan with the perforated bottom, and I just put here my cod. I do this in the oven, and I use a normal oven plate to catch the water what drips off. Then I switch on my oven. I press here on the button of home. Then I go to steaming. I select the temperature. I go to 85 degrees. Then I select the time, and the time depends on the thickness of the fillet. So it's about 5 or 6 minutes, but these fillets are not very thick. So this time I use 5 minutes, and then I select play. That's it. Steam oven is done, so I can open the door. As you can see, a lot of steam is coming out of the steam oven, so it's important to have a good door in stainless steel above your steamer, because it's resistant to the steam. As you can see, the fish is ready. The cod you can serve on hot plates, of course, because you have a dish warmer in your kitchen. Just add some pepper and salt and enjoy your meal. In my video, I can't tell you everything, so I hope you understand that it's better to visit my showroom and to talk about it in real. But I have a lot of accessories available, like the sliding chopping board in different colors or the bar stools. Usually the clients choose for this one because it looks nice, it's cheap, and you can put it below the worktop. But if you want to sit on the island for hours, I really would recommend this bar stool. And it's slightly more expensive, but it sits way better. And it's a better quality tool, to be honest. And like this, I have a lot of things to tell. So you're invited to see this in real, and I hope you will like it. Bye bye.